of what Christ has accomplished many centuries ago. It doesn't matter how many times you've heard the message over and over and over again. But I tell you the truth, that every time that the word comes, God speaks to the hearts of men. Do you have ears to hear what the Spirit is saying unto you today? It becomes an open invitation, regardless of who you are, or your status in life. You might deem yourself to be a good person, but yet you are still a sinner in need of His grace, in need of His mercy. And Jesus came to save us from the consequence of our sin. You see, something transpire in the Garden of Eden. And what have transpired in the Garden of Eden? That which was rightly his property, now God have to buy back. That's why the word is redeem. Redemption. To purchase that which was rightly his in the first place, for our souls belongs to God. But because of what have transpired in the Garden of Eden, now God have to buy back that which was rightly his. Today is another golden opportunity, because today, if you come the way you are, He will not turn you away. He said, "Behold, I stand at the door and I knock." You might be wondering, which door is he speaking about? Is it the side door, the front door, or the back door? He's speaking about the door of your heart. And the good news is, Jesus is past sin this way. He's passing this way today. You see, when we look into the Word of God, we have concluded that everyone that walks the face of planet Earth is in need of God's grace, in need of God's mercy, which He make known to His Son, Jesus Christ. And He said, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear what He has to say." Hear what He has to say. And He said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. he came that you might have life. He is the life-giving spirit. The word he speaks, they are spirit and they are life. Has a part of life in himself, so have he given unto the Son to have life in himself. Has the Father raised up the dead and quickened them, even so the Son quickened whomsoever he will, for he is the Son of Man. Today, my brothers and sisters, all I'm trying to bring to your attention that there is an urgency in the cry, the call to repentance, the call to salvation, the invitation to come and be a part of that which God is doing in the here and the now. Patience for days, as old as you are, as old as you are, he will never change. He remains the same. His love is constant. God is love. And he unveiled his love to the person of his Son, even the man Jesus Christ. He is the love of God that has been shed abroad in our heart, and we communicate this love that God has for his creation. So he commands men everywhere to repent. He commands men everywhere.
Hey, God bless you.
Bless you.
To repent. You might be saying, why should I repent? What have I done wrong? But the Bible says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, and the place where Christ have gone to prepare, no sin can enter therein. So sin got to be dealt with now. Salvation is being offered unto you now. You see, he is the one that created us all. So he don't favor the rich over the poor, nor the white over the black. He don't show partiality. He don't show favoritism. So he becomes an equal opportunity. And the word says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever, and he is the one that is the guarantor that guarantees eternal life. He's the one to whom it all pertains.